Yeah, and if it doesn't crit, it's 800k.
Yeah, but like that's not gonna make or break it. Like not holding tyrants could be an issue.
Can I queue up, or you want to change your character?
Electra holds. Electra also doesn't hold Bellarellos. I'm not looking at Pot at the moment either, so. Spindle? 2 minute CD. Okay, he does have that. Alec doesn't save his recklessness. Oh, wait. Did he die? Yeah, oh, no, never mind. He died just before he would have used his wreck. Yeah, no, so that's not an issue. Berserk. Diplo just flat out forgot his second Berserk. Alright, let's go for another pull. 3 minute 20, ideally. Or just one of the late. We're 316, close enough.
You tell me when to queue up, right, Penguin?
Yeah, I'm just customizing.
That's fine.
Yeah. That's sick. Right, I'm good.
Saying, right, it literally is the fact that because I've just looked at a few pulls, right, and there's some pulls when like there's some people doing like literally zero damage. And there's other pulls when myself, for example, I did 200k on this pull, and Crimson did like pretty much the same. And then on all the other pulls, Crimson and I are pretty like near the bottom, but that's evidently just because we're not even focusing on hitting the boss. Like, I'm just focused so much on the orb, so it's not that we don't have the damage. It's just people need to get used to it.
What do we do?
Have you played this?
No.
Actually, delusional.
So TLDR is your like first two buttons. First one is just attacking; it's a normal combo. The second one is healing, and you can loot things to get more spells.
As a battle royale.
I'm in battle.
Yeah, and we both fly the same mount, I think. Like when we drop down, yeah.
Oh, that's not a cooldown.
And I'm hot dropping us, because it's funnier.
I'm on your ass, boy.
Died before he could get another one of that. Jammy is not holding Call of the Wild. Diplo is not holding Berserk.
Oh yeah, take that.
I'm not sure you can account for...
It doesn't do a lot of damage, but it's undodgeable.
What's that, Kira?
Isn't for Incarn, like...
Incarn?
3 minute cooldown?
Berserk, isn't that spell?
They're bad guys.
Because it's a 2 minutes, because he uses it at, like, on 1 second. Well, and 155... Oh, he's got combo points, obviously, to reduce it, but you cannot reduce it enough to, like, use it at 155 and then again at 310, or 3 minutes even. You do not have that level of CDR. It's approximately 145 to 215, depending on your combo points.
Are you dead, Tom?
So Diplo should be holding,
but
he's
not. If you beat
him,
you can stand on my corpse and res me.
No, he's gonna come with that.
Yeah.
Dotham's good. Wings, yeah, here you didn't hold. Oh wait, this might be where you die. Yeah, you died 5 seconds before you would have wings.
Go next.
Oh, how do I leave? Leave that.
Yeah.
I leave for...
Once you get used to it a bit more, it gets way better.
I'm ready.
Crimson and Reese have nothing to hold.
Big jump. Thing is we want to kill normal mobs as much as possible because that gives us levels.
Okay.
And abilities.
The jumpy done. 304.
Oh, and most normal mobs cannot ever really deal damage to you.
I don't like the fact that it's like RNT though. I don't use RNT.
Yeah, you can rebind it.
Yeah. Onyx. Oh, I got my favorite ability. Let's go.
Wait, Jumpy missed a whole ass tyrant? Okay, Jumpy just missed a whole ass tyrant.
So I like how you kept on saying, I don't distrust you, I distrust you.
Basically. No, it wasn't that. Basically, I had the same thing where it wasn't working for me. I don't actually remember, I kept getting a double. And I downloaded Vodka's thing, and there was something in there that was still conflicting, and I just want to double check if he had that.
Oh, Tom.
Yeah?
I know why they're not holding Bellarellos.
Why?
They both run double on you, so you can't. They spindle with a tyrant.
you can Belorolos later on. That turn is like 30 seconds.
No, but let me just check where they saw the maelstrom. 3:35. Oh, that just means their second Belorolos is too. No, it's a 2-minute CD. Yeah. Yeah, they could hold, but they're not.
Who's flying me?
Alright, Jemmy.
Probably me because I'm party leader. We're dropping right below us again.
As far as CD holding goes, it's you could say the two Belorelluses, Jemmy's Call of the Wild and Diplo's Berserk, but that's it. Everyone else is either holding or waiting or using it because they'll have it again at the 3-minute mark and it'll last at about 20 seconds, which is the rest of the Corruption Shield. So that's not a big issue. Call of the Wild is a big CD, right?
Yeah. The 2 minutes, yeah.
Yeah, so so as far as true CD holding goes, it's just Berserk and Call of the Wild.
I got Lightning Bulwark.
Hmm?
Lightning Bulwark is fine. Defensive. Yeah. Also, pick up gold for more EXP.
Yeah, I got that one. Jet XP, all.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, just to prove my point, right? What I did, I went to the pool where we beat the shield, 60%, and I looked at casts during the intermission, yeah? Mm-hmm. I then gone to all the other pools that were similar length, that had even somewhat close casts. Like, sometimes, so the one where we beat it, we had like 750 casts per minute. And then I looked at anything that was above 500. On each of those pools, everyone is doing like much better damage, like decent damage, mostly. There's a few people under 100k. So that, if that's not proof in the pudding that it's people getting used to it, then I don't know what it is.
By the way, you say 750, I'm looking at the intermission and I see 1260 casts a minute.
Just casts, sorry, not casts per minute. Just casts at the bottom, total.
Oh, yeah, 778. Yeah.
So, like, look at the pools, which are, like, somewhat similar. I cut off at 500. And then damage. And it's not even that bad.
Where is the... Which one was the pool where we were 800k away?
I don't.
Well, it must have been the longest pool. That must be the longest intermission, so it has to be the 321, probably. Yeah.
No, there's one that's... Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It has to be the 321. But the problem is we also had half... We had also had people dead there, so... Well, but let's just ignore three deaths. And then our CPM is 1214. So we're around the same.
Like, you can use
that
as an indicator, right? As to how much people are actually trying to break the shield rather than focusing on the orbs.
So, I mean, generally, yeah.
Obviously, if the casts are higher, then people are more comfortable.
Oh, that's big!
I mean, not... In some cases, yeah, but you also have to take class into account, you know?
Yeah, but obviously class is consistent amongst every pool, so it doesn't matter
that's
about
like
class.
That's like the best spell in the
Yeah, Cap and Thokal, for instance, differ by like 1.2 CPM.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You and Crimson differ by 1.8 on this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Palifar, 70.2 and 67, like, that's kind of potato.
And then if you look at the other pools, like the really shit, the shit ones where the shield was like diabolical, casts are like 200.
Well, also because we had many pools where L2 Shadow went through and then like half the raid is dead.
Yeah, exactly.
After first orb, so but then CPM stops being a relevant indicator because there's 10 people not casting.
What are you on about?
If you cut off...
People fighting with you.
Or you cut off the 3 deaths.
If you, yeah, cut off after... die, then you use it as a somewhat reliable metric, but it's still not that good.
No, I don't think you can use it as a reliable metric at all.
Use firewall.
I don't know how it works. You didn't tell me that, you just said to take it.
Like, now let's say I grab all these casts. Like here on the one where we died on 3 minutes, which is first set of orbs, first orb going through. We also have 1200 CPM.
Can you stream where you're looking?
Oh, here's a shit one. 254, it was our first pull. Let's look at that. 800 TPM, but that's... Oh, wait, ignore after three. Oh, no data available because we were already more than three dead. That explains why it was a shit pull.
I don't think I can res you.
They're not fighting, they're running away.
I can't, you're under storm.
Oh.
I'm seeing, race. I'm mostly seeing 1050 to 1200 CPM range from the raid at that point.
I think it's going to be one of the things that is going to become easier the more we do it.
Hardest part of the fight.
Yeah.
I do want to point out, though, by the way, I am confidently at the top of the first three deaths, but that's because Divi forgot several spell wardings at the start.
More than one.
Yeah, two or three timed outs. That's when I realized. At first, I thought it was my mistake, but then I realized, like, hang on, you're doing a bit too early.
Well, I'm doing it when the timer was. It's just a little bit too early. Basically, I have to press it once it's attacking us, and then press.
Yeah,
it.
once the first move comes out, because that was I had one or two that was fucked from people running ahead, and then there was just one where it shouldn't have been. Beyond that, most people have very balanced causes of death. Like if you ignore after three.
There's one external that I might want.
Which is?
Because I'm saving a lot of stuff so I don't die during the transition.
Yeah, I just need to macro you in, honestly.
No, but once... But the thing is, I'm popping so much at that point to make sure I don't die. I think I'm fine.
Fuck.
I'd rather you do it before then. So when I take him to the middle and he jumps on me...
Already.
Yeah, for the Mythic Souls?
No, the second set? For the tank, the Bates.
Yeah.
So that first hit really fucking trucks me because he's just jumped at me and then he frontals me. And it's that frontal is almost killing me, like, every time.
But is that... When is that? You say when he jumps to the middle, but that's around second Mythic Soaks.
It's before them. So...
Fire circles, and then we go over, right?
Yeah, so Penguin pulls him over to the corner after the transition.
Yeah, so that is the point I'm referring to. Then I know which moment you mean.
You do the soaks, you do some frontals... And then after that, he jumps at me towards the middle, where I'm stood.
Yeah.
Because he's frontaled me, so I got the front. He's got the jump debuff on me, and then he does a frontal at me quite swiftly afterwards, and that frontal is the one that is, like, trucking me real hard.
Yeah. Okay, five of my deaths were...
After that,
yeah. I
just catch up for a while.
All right, then if you just call out the exact moment you want, because Paint's up is only 8 seconds.
Basically, as soon as you see the dude appear in front of me, just put it on me then.
Okay. It's like, yeah, of course, I had one predator death because I accidentally dotted instead of shielded.
Also, I need to get a bit more used to actually calling things.
Yeah,
my
you,
brain
you,
when
you,
I die.
You
just
stopped,
off.
And I was like, stop fucking stopping.
Yeah.
But yeah, Dark Embers, Davy, at least three of them were your fault.
Me.
You left me to die.
I mean, if it wore off on you and I did it at the correct time, I'm not sure it's my fault for sure.
Nah, it's just a sheet timing thing.
I got the timing down on the dream rounds anyway.
Like you have here, I've got one frontal, one firestorm. That was two spawned in front of me as I was going to my spot. It's just like, yeah, shit. Either I plop it in the middle and ruin roots, or I have to try and run through it and I'll probably die to firestorm. And then there's a shadow flame, a blaze, a wildfire, a corrupt, and the other wildfire. That was the random jump after the first Mythic Soaks that I wasn't expecting and didn't see. Holy fuck, Tom died to everything.
Yeah.
Literally everything, what the fuck?
Again, I think we made the first part of that fight towards the end, like we made the first part of that fight so much cleaner again. If we can start getting to the point where we're getting everyone through.
one thing that was going a bit all over the place was where the mythic soaks were, because that caused problems.
Yeah, we had several deaths from that.
I mean, coping with everything else was fine. It's just like that was one of the things that seemed to be getting looser is where people stood for those.
There is one thing we actually really need to get better at. Blazes. 100%. I got sniped by those directly once and once or twice where it's like blaze hits, I'm at 30k,
I mean,
rot damage takes me dead.
We got a lot better at that towards the end as well.
I'm baiting a huge amount though.
I feel like a few people aren't getting better at it though. Like I'm seeing Crimson move a lot with him.
The one thing I find annoying is when I'm stood like literally next to one. Like, I'm behind it. I've got a mark on my head, so I'm going to point it exactly away from the raid, and someone runs directly at it and, like, snipes it off me towards the raid.
Oh, with the bait?
Yeah.
No, we were still referring to the blazes, the lines. But you also mentioned, like, can you stop sniping me with the blaze, but genuinely, like, nobody is watching you at that stage.
Yeah, but they need to just not... Like, the amount of times when, like, multiple ones are aimed directly at me and I can't move...
You also have to imagine they're trying not to hit six others as well around them. Like, that's kind of the thing.
Yeah, but it's the fact that they move to be on top of me. It's not that they're moving around and then they happen to catch me. It's they move exactly on top of me and stop.
If you want to move...
Anywhere else would be fine.
I mean, I'm not going
to
lie.
Spell slot, you have to hold down tab and then right-click it, by the way.
Yeah.
They shouldn't even be moving on top of you. They should be moving the fucking line along the line.
Yeah.
That's my point, is that, like, why am I getting all these things aimed at me? I don't understand.
I think I have a great excuse to yeet myself halfway across the raid. It's because after that, I have to stand still to heal.
I mean, I actually move quite a bit with blazers, but that's mostly when I try to bait. When I like line up. I'm close to one. I'm not close to one. I'm obviously not gonna fucking sprint there.
Well, this is why I was saying again, like, towards the end it got better, because where we had more space for people, like, early on there was no space at all. So everyone was kind of moving around like a headless chicken. When we created the space, partly my fault as well, I'm not gonna deny that, because I had to get used to how people were gonna be moving with,
People are moving across, Penguin.
Where?
Yeah, me.
But if you look at the death logs, you're gonna see a wild variety of first killing blows. With, I believe, literally most of Tom is second highest in deaths, but I think maybe one or two of that were directly his fault.
Yes. I liked dying to the first orb like 80 times.
Only twice as part of the first three deaths, at least.
You guys die?
Shut the fuck up, Red Paladin.
These guys have fucking insane abilities.
Okay, Tom, two Dark Flame Cleaves, not your fault. Two Shadow Orbs.